Welcome to another video of the RShiny dashboard series. In this particular video, we're going to explore how we can create a fluid layout using the sidebar. It's also called the sidebar layout. This is how the layout looks. You have certain inputs on this sidebar and whatever charts needs to be displayed, they will be displayed on the right hand side. And this is going to be called as the main panel. And while we are using or writing the code, this is going to be called the sidebar panel. And this layer that we are speaking about, it's going to be called as a sidebar layout. And then we'll also have another small layout that is called the title panel. And this is the place where the title goes. Now, the whole layout or the whole page is going to be called as fluid page, as opposed to the basic page that we have in the previous apps. So let's look at the app that we have built so far. We basically built an app that looks like this. We have imported the three main libraries required for this. We have a server where all of the manipulations for the data go in, and then it serves the plot from here and the drop down from here in the UI page in this basic page layout. This is how it looks like. The problem with this layout is if I expand it, the chart is going to expand along with it, and none of these elements are cohesive. So let's see how we can improve this layout using the fluid layout and the sidebar layout. Now I've moved to this 9 code here where I have basically everything same within this code. And now what we're going to do is introduce that layout available. The one thing that I do usually is I go to the layout gallery in this place and I pick up the code that is available here and then paste it. So this is the place that I have the code with me, where I'm simply going to pick up this UI layout that is available here, and then I'm going to go to this code and paste it just above the UI that I have here. Now I'm just going to say press enter and press double enter here, and now I'm going to select the UI that I have and I'm going to now comment this. So this is commented. All we need to do now is that this particular layout needs to take all of the elements from here and then place it accordingly, right? But first let's see how this layout is going to be looking like, just like this, right? So I'm going to say save here, and the layout is going to be something like this. Where you have an input, the chart is obviously not there, but you'll have an input here and then the chart will be placed here, right? So let's see how we can replace all those elements. Remember, we have this title element where the title goes in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take this header one that is available for me here. I'm going to copy that here and place it there. Or rather, I'll just copy the text and I will place it here. Now I have the title in place. All I need to do now is take my select input and put it in that place. So I'm just going to copy this here and paste it in this place. Right, I'm going to uncomment this, so that is uncommented. Okay, so now you'll see that title panel that we have. We've got that already, and this is the name we got. We got the select input, and it's placed in the sidebar panel. Right, so this is the sidebar panel. We have now taken the select input that we had and placed it there, and obviously all of this is enclosed within the sidebar layout, right? So this entire thing is a sidebar layout. We have the sidebar panel and this is the main panel, right? Now obviously within the main panel is where we want to show the plot, and this is the plot that we want to show. So I'm just going to copy that and place it here. So now I have my input and my plot within the main channel, and the sidebar panel has a select input. This is all enclosed within the sidebar layout, and the title panel is available on the top. Now if I save this and run the app, now we should have a similar layout. So if I expand it, now you'll see that this layout is much more better. The user knows where the input is and the chart is now present here, and you can simply change the values here, and you'll see that the fluid layout or the sidebar layout is now fully active with user input in the sidebar, and the main bar has the chart. Now there is a lot of controls within this. We can place all of the parameters that we want to show within this dashboard here, and all of the charts or the values or the results that we want to display can be there in the main area. So this is how we basically convert this basic page into a fluid page and then convert it into a sidebar layout, which has a sidebar panel and a main panel. Now with this, our app is much more better to run and looks much more professional. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.